talk a little bit about recharging our lives, utilizing philosophy of habit. And this is going to be like kind of a philosophical take on habit, bridging science in with also a clear action step. You know, a lot of people this time of year start looking at planning more, planning ahead to add more to their plate, to add a different thing to their plate. But often it's not that we need to add more. It's often that we need to look at what we already have, take what's already here, and reassess and recharge and add life. Now, here comes the science. So 40 to 45% of our lives, okay, almost the majority of our lives, right? Almost at the half mark, is habituated. And we can think of it kind of like riding a bike, right? When you're first learning how to ride a bike, you're utilizing all this mental energy, all this physical energy, you're really hyper-focused, all the things, you're like, you're all in, right? And then you eventually learn and you eventually pick it up. And once you pick that up, now, I don't know about you guys, but like I can ride a bike, text or do an in-story or talk to somebody next to me. I'm listening to an audiobook. I'm doing a thousand things on this bike where when I was first learning how to ride the bike, it took so much energy and love. So we got to look at our lives. If 40 to 45% of our lives are habituated, this is actually a good thing. And it's here to help our brains kind of deal with life because we're getting all of these things thrown at us in life. Literally so much information, so much stimulation that if we had to be as present with everything as we are when we're a child and we're learning about life and how this life, our brains would explode, which is why kids sleep so much, by the way, fun fact, because they take in so much information, they're processing so much. So what we do to cope with that biologically is we create habits. We do these things that become habituated in our lives. So one less thing to think about, like brushing our teeth or walking or walking down the stairs, like that's a big deal for little kids. But now we're just like do-do-do-do-do, on the phone, texting, doing all the things, walking up and down the stairs. Because before that was like life or death for your child. So if our life is almost majority, almost half habituated, and you're feeling like you're kind of stalled out or things aren't that exciting or like things could use a little boost or recharge, we really get to look at what the habituated part of our life is. Because that's the opportunity to shift, right? Like, yes, there's all these new things that we're doing and there's new things that we're taking on, but it's the habituated part that becomes monotonous.